Her daily drive at this time was a metaphysical demonstration in her eyes.
She told one worker, "I do not take this drive for recreation, but because I want to establish my dominion over mortal mind's antagonistic beliefs."
The drive demonstrated to a curious world that she was still the active leader, despite persistent rumors that she was not.
One day, Mrs. Sargent told me that a car with reporters from the Boston Traveler had followed the carriage. Mrs. Eddy asked, "What do they want, Calvin?" He replied, "Your picture, Mother." She said, "Well, let them have it." And Mrs. Eddy leaned forward for them to take the picture. Adelaide Still.
The press and their rumors were quieted for a day. The 20-minute drive, usually around nearby Chestnut Hill Reservoir, gave her private time to observe, reflect, and often pray.
"I have uttered some of my best prayers in a carriage," she said. During one drive, she observed, "Every leaf upon every tree declares perpetually that God is love."
Day after day, people standing on tiptoe to gawk into her carriage windows intruded on those private moments. A neighboring child once took up a vantage point at the main gate. One day, the girl's stare was particularly insolent, perhaps influenced by hateful remarks about Mrs. Eddy she had heard.
"The man who drove the horses for Mrs. Eddy came in very incensed and wishing to punish that girl. Just at that moment, Mrs. Eddy called for him and sent him with an attractive basket of peaches and her card expressing love to the girl he wanted to punish. The girl never bothered again and was full of apology for her rudeness. Of course, the realization of God's allness and man's unity with him must accompany such a gift to bring out healing, as it did in this case." Minnie Scott.